Another thing people are asking about is when can you start a TRE schedule in a person's life, like developmentally?
Yeah.
Can you start as a toddler? Is that too early? I mean,
I think, so we know that in newborn, the suprachiasmatic nucleus is not even fully developed, mm-hmm. and it may not be even fully connected to the rest of the body. And that makes sense because the babies are going through a very rapid growth phase. And what they need at that time is a lot of nutrition and growth. So TRE may not be desirable at that time, not at all. Since it can trigger adverse effects, so I won't recommend. I think the rule of thumb is when babies or toddlers begin to sleep 8 to 9 hours continuously through the night, anyways, now their physiology or their sleep pattern is already getting used to being without food for 7 to 8 or maybe 9 hours. And that may be a time when at least one can begin the first phase of time-restricted eating, that is, to start with a scheduled or well-defined morning breakfast time or the last meal or even bedtime. So recently there was a study done in England showing that babies who are having a very regular scheduled bedtime and also last meal are protected from childhood obesity even 5, 6, 7 years down the road. Mm-hmm. So although they did not measure when these babies were eating and all that stuff, what I think is having a regular bedtime itself is a very strong timing cue that these babies are going to bed at a certain time, and most babies will sleep for 8, 9, even 10 hours. So they're already into 10 hours of fasting just through their sleep. And then it takes an hour for them to get up and then get ready and then start eating. Or for some babies, they may finish eating and then they're reading a book or something and somebody's reading them a storybook. So that you'd add that 1 hour between the last food and going to bed. So in that way, I think the rule of thumb would be when babies start to sleep for 8 to 9 hours continuously, then that would be a good time to start putting them to bed at fixed time. And then the next thing would be giving them breakfast at the same time every day or having the last meal or the dinner time fixed. So then their body gets used to it. And then by the time they're in elementary school, it'll be easy for them to adopt a 12 hours eating time, and then if they want, maybe they can go down to 10 or 12, so that itself is a very good limit on them. So in that way, I think it's a very clear example that TRE is something that you can start very early on, and it can be a lifelong habit.
Excellent.